U.S. Navy lieutenant named Darn Wall, who took the triage to the bottom of the Mariana Trench.
Yes, 36,000 feet below.
Sir, you've been noticeably silent. What's your interest in the world beneath the waters?
I've just been waiting for my turn. Is it my turn?
No, not yet.
Great. 1960, we learned about your exploration of the
the valuable fur trade that brought about the greatest exploration of North America. Let's go back to Professor's Dream Machine and see what it can tell us.
Yeah. about Poussin.
No way, dude! I do not believe that CC was not the first.
Only his record of journey was not a first, not his journey.
Hey, man! You must have animals triumphed in adventure. Look at these threads, dude!
My own friends, I am Pythias, a Greek citizen of Massilia. I am known as a mathematician and astronomer. I lived on Earth during the 4th century B.C.
Oh, right! That means it must be
you did.
Cross the continent, we did. Africa, and not made the continent of Australia. You know, the land down under.
Then you must be Robert O'Hara Burke and William John Wills.
Aye, that we be, mate. Took ourselves on a little walkabout through the bush, we did.
I dare say. And what, my good man, is a walkabout?
It's an Aboriginal habit. Means to wander around and discover new places. We just happened to walk about up north into the Never Never Land.
Ah, yes. And if I have my facts straight, you chaps were the first to travel from Melbourne in the south to the Gulf of Carpentaria in the north, some 1,500 miles of unknown land.
Aye, that we be, matey. Mangrove swamps actually kept us from the shore, but we made it to the Gulf.
It was the returning that killed us.
We were 30 miles away from our base camp, and the others, not knowing it, packed up the camp and left just 9 hours before we got there. That was the final straw. We had no strength left.
I kept my journal right up to the last I did.
Hey, that you did, mate. That you did.
You died shortly after I did.
Aye, that I did, mate. That I did.
Come, man. Stiff up and lip and all that, you know.
Quite right. The government of Australia has raised both monuments and statues in your honor right in the city square. All Aussies remember your own feat of crossing great deserts with howling winds and mountains of torrential rains.
And who might you be, mate?
Dr. Livingston, I presume.
Indeed. You know, Stanley, I left my wife and four children to spend 28 years of my life as a missionary and explorer in Africa, and I only converted one native to Christianity. What's more, I can't claim much in the field of exploration, except for Victoria Falls and the source of the Congo River.
Dr. Livingston, it was your articles that I published in the New York Herald in 1871 that excited Europe to action. Europe was aghast that in government's pressure, the Sultan of Zanzibar to close down his lucrative slave market. When the people read your tales about the horrors of the slave market, you brought about the defeat of this awful practice.
And to think people thought I was strange. I can't imagine.